Hello students, welcome to our SST classroom. Now students, in the last video we started our chapter, right students? That is lesson number 13, human resources. Okay students, and in that we have discussed about that what is human resources. So students, can you tell me what is human resources? The people of our country call it human resources. Okay, so students, we have learned that there are many resources in our country, but the resources itself is of no use if the people don't know how to use it, right? So the students, the people of our country, use their skills and efficiency to use these resources. Okay, and also we have discussed about that due to ever increasing population, people face many problems. Example, shortage of food and water. Right students, because of ever increasing population, people face a problem of shortage of food and water. Students, you can see here in the image, the picture, the small children, you can see the condition. It can understood that this child is facing the problem of scarcity of food, right? And also scarcity of water. Students, if there are even so much people, if you are using the water for their daily needs, so people will face the problem of scarcity of water, shortage of water. Okay, so students, just take example of apple. Right? If you are only the one child in the family, you are having the apple, so you have the whole apple. Right students? If you are having your brother, you have to share it. If you are having two brothers, you have to share in three parts. So like that, if there is an ever increasing population, so there people will face the problem of shortage of food and water. Okay students? Now we'll see shortage of schools and colleges. Students, you know that if there is very less schools and colleges in our country, so people will get, there will be a limited seat in the schools and college. So the remaining will not get the seats in the school and college. So they will face a problem, they will be they will not get the seats in the school. So shortage of schools and college. Because of ever increasing population, people will face the problem of shortage of schools and colleges. Okay, now next we have discussed about the illiteracy. If the people will not get educated, if the people will not go to school, so they will be illiterate, they will be face, they will be uneducated, right? Then next we have discussed about increasing unemployment. As we can say that because of ever increasing population, so less will get the job. If see, you can see here in the picture, he is educated but he does not get the job in the any companies. Why? Because there are already the seats are full and he did not get the job. Though he is educated, he did not get the job. So students, because of ever increasing population, people can face the problem of unemployment. Okay, and the last we discuss about that increasing poverty. Okay students, first what we have discussed about the shortage of food and water, shortage of schools and colleges, illiteracy, increasing unemployment. Now students, if the people will not get all these, the people will not be educated, will not get a proper food and water, so what will happen? Our this will increase in poverty. Yes students, you can see here in the picture that there are so many, there you can see the faces of the child and others, that they are in the poverty. Right, they did not get enough food to eat, they did not get they did not educated, and they did not go to school. So because of ever increasing population, there will be a increase in poverty. Okay, now students, let's discuss about that what the government has taken step to solve all these problems. Okay, now let's learn about the step taken by the government. Okay, students. So students, the government has taken various steps to minimize the problem caused by overpopulation. Okay, so what step the government has taken that we are going to learn here one by one. First, the government has organized different programs to provide employment opportunities. Okay, now students, to check the migration from village to cities, government just checking the migration, why the people they go from village to cities. So for that, the government understood that the people they did not get job, they did not have any work in the village, so that's why they shift from village to city in search of work. So what the government has taken step in the villages, the government organized different programs to provide employment opportunities. Even the government has taken the step to educate the people by free of cost, right? To give the knowledge of computer in free of cost in the village, and also to give the educate the old adult. Also, the government have organized the program. Okay, students. Now, students, see, you can see here in the image, this woman, they work in the cottage, they work in the village. Okay, and now students, they have the skills to make basket, to make a different things, but they did not have the market to sell, right? So what the government is doing, the government purchase this product from the villages and it sells to the open market. Okay, in this way the government help the villages by organizing different program. Okay, I hope the first step you have understood. Now second step, availability of better medical facilities. Now students, mostly you have seen in the village there are very few hospitals are there, right? So what the people they do for their better medical facility, they have to shift from village to cities. So now what the government has taken the step, the government give the better medical facilities in the villages also. Okay, so people will not shift from village to city for their medical facilities. Okay, the next one is land has been given to landless farmer. Students, the farmer, those who are not having the land for their agriculture, so what the government has taken the step, the government has been providing a land to the landless farmer. Okay, then next, school and colleges are open in villages. Okay students, now just take example, if in the village there are very less schools and colleges, so what the people will have to do, they have to go for other village, they have to go to the other cities, right? But some of them were very afraid to send their child to go to the other villages, or they are not having the enough money for the transport to go to the to send their child in the other cities. So because of that, what happened, they are not getting the they are not educated, so they stop their education till, so students, they are not allowing their child to go to the other villages or other cities. Okay, they stop their education. So for this, what the government has done, what the government has done, taken the step, the government opened the schools and colleges in all the everyone will get educated in villages. Okay, now the last one, that is spreading awareness about birth control method. Now students, to avoid the ever increasing population, what the government has taken the step, the government have organized a different advertisement and also seminar to aware the people about the birth control, about the birth control. Okay, the government has the government also give the slogan about that benefit to have a small family, right? You can see here in the image, the government by giving the advertisement about the family planning and a small family benefit for having a small family, the government have give the different advertisement to aware the people of about the birth control. Okay, I hope students you have understood all the step which the government has taken to solve all this problem. Okay students, now students, what you are going to do, you have to read the textbook and you will write all the step which the government has taken to solve this problem, you have to write in your notebook. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.